challenging, but it was very, very useful. Would it be possible to get this live when you plan to share them?
Yes, I am. Where would you like them on?
I don't know, if you can put them online or whatever.
Right.
Even on SlideShare or any service that you use, it would be useful.
Alright.
I'll really find
Do you want to give me your email address?
Yeah, sure, yeah.
I was just waiting for them to email me to say send me the slides, but if they don't do that, I'll send you them manually.
I can write you. And I had a question as well, which was one of your cultures at the end, when you said the file names aren't guaranteed to be valued yet paid out with Linux.
Yeah.
How do you solve this problem? Because I currently have this problem. I'm using Japanese characters as a file name in a file, and then I get errors like file doesn't exist because probably it's not then able to understand that it's a Japanese character.
Right. Well, that might not be. They might actually be encoded in TF8, so that might not be the problem. The underlying problem may be that you're mixing byte strings and character strings. But if that is the case, it's just about invalid UTF-8. All you have to do is use valid byte strings. Because all byte strings are just a sequence of bytes, and that's what file names are. But it is a tricky... Because of Windows and OS 10. And Python 3 did a function.
If I use byte strings, then it's a safe and I shouldn't have problems.
Yeah, on Linux,
Okay, shall I write it?
Oh, I'd draw a keyboard.
Well, it's Sandro. CIRULLI @OUP.com.
Is that right?
Yeah, that's right.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll send you
Cheers. Thank you very much.
site called the proworkshop.nl. That's the website. You're welcome there. I still for 5 seconds? Okay.
Sometimes for
course you can do it in XS. Control 4, and I mean, my journey started here, right, 1992, that's a long time from now. So what the match looks like, it's called, as said, slides from what prepared, it's called Devil Pick Pope. It goes by, you know, by Zephyr, what it does, and basically what you can do is you can pick an address and it will return you, sorry, it can pick at an address a particular number of bytes, and it can also poke to an address a particular string of bytes. And all this happens in pure prose. So how does it work? In order to explain that, I have to go a little bit into what Perl data structures actually are. They are nothing more than C structs, normally linked C structs, like several of them. For example, in order to store a string, you have a so-called SE, which is a structure with four fields, and then it points to the so-called EV, which is actually your string with some other stuff around it. And there is a module that comes with Perl itself, it's called B. I think it is described as the backend to the Perl compiler. And it has a very interesting function in there, which basically you can take any reference at all, and you can say, give me the B object of this reference. And what it will do is it will create an inside-out object which holds only the address of this SV in memory somewhere that you're representing right there. And it allows you to call methods on it, and it basically does all the hard work into, by interfacing what is in memory C-wise and representing. So this is our implementation, and it's actually a topic that today we started and think that it's as the model. take that as well, which is easy. You just take reference to the string.
Come on.